Yo, what's up, guys? Keldeo, Zeus up to your back with another Pokemon video. So today I will be going over the Crown Zenith set list. So yeah, I know pretty much nothing about the set, so all these are gonna be my first impression. I'm gonna be talking about mostly expand stuff, but I'll do some standard, maybe a little bit. So yeah, let's get right into it. Oddish, Gloom, Blossom Lines. This does 80 damage for each head, 3 coins, which is one of your bench Pokemon. Ooh, that's kinda interesting. I mean, you could like just switch that with like a doll or something. If you'd like Victini. Let's say you get like 2 out of 3. That's like 160 damage. I mean, it's not terrible, and then retreat to like a doll or item lock or something like that. What else we got here? Leafeon, I'm looking ahead a little bit. I like this is like a mini set, right? So there might be reprints. I actually have idea. Interesting there. So we got a Leafeon. Is this a different Leafeon? Let me look at it on the side. Yeah, this is a different Leafeon. Okay. Probably not as good, right? Because it doesn't have that ability that searches for the energy. We got a V-Star, which we switch one of your opponent's bench with their active Pokemon. So that's a boss. That's pretty much like Umbreon, right? But evolved. But this is ability. Ability boss is was there like another thing like this? I don't know. I don't know if there has been like an ability boss. Oh wait, no wait, no wait. Wait, hold on. No. No, I'm pretty sure I played Leafeon in a deck and I did this actually. Never mind, I'm done. No, this is just a reprint. Well, this is just a reprint, but instead of promo, it's in the set. All right, that's awkward. A grass Calyrex. What? A grass Calyrex. What the heck? That makes no sense. Surely this guy's not a grass type, right? What is its official typing? Calyrex. It's a. Oh, wait, it can be. Oh, wait, it's psychic grass. Huh. I never knew that. Okay. What does it do? I think this is like the first. This has to be like the first. King Pokemon, wow. That has to be like the first, like, normal Calyrex. Search your deck for two cards, put them in your deck, eh? For like a DCE. That's kind of good. Plus you do some damage. That's kind of good. Don't know if I ever play that deck, but that's not bad. So we got a Grub and then none of the evolutions, or they might be lightning types. Alright, so we got Charizard. Okay, so these are reprints, right? Yeah, these are reprints. Radiant Charizard, another reprint. Yeah, why would this first Radiant reprint? Huh. Oh, this is like, oh, that's like a shiny one. That's pretty cool. This one was really expensive, so people are glad that there's gonna be a reprint because the price will definitely go down. We got Simisear, another reprint, but V-Star. Discard 5 cards, stack your deck, 40 more damage for each card you discard this way. So you could do like 240. All right, and then each damage in the discard pile. I mean, that's pretty much like Volcarona, but you don't put them back. But you can only use it once. But it does a little bit more damage, so kind of, but not really. It's a pretty good slam dip. All right, underwater, going straight past, going quickly through this one. It's a mini set, but they're still like under 50 cards, so. What we got from here? Put 3 energy and. Oh, this is like a 180 damage snipe. Wait, this is pretty good, what the heck? So you keep the energy, you put it back in your hand, and then. Damn, this is pretty good, man. What the heck? 180, bro. You could just snipe Crobats and Denny's for like days, dude. What the heck? Like, you definitely pair this with like Frostmoth, but bro, that's pretty good. What the heck? I'm gonna take write that down, dude, so I can make a deck from. Yeah, it's actually really good. I mean, like, four energy is definitely doable. That's only like one like superior energy retrieval, but I mean, you're gonna keep it all in your hand, so damn. I mean, this probably would be good in like any like water deck, but like, bro, you could make a whole freaking deck out of this guy, dude. Kyogre V is the first Kyogre V, I think so. Nothing too insane. Glaceon V. This might be a reprint. Lightning got doubles of all these guys. One of them are Rapid Strikes. Is this a reprint? Feel like the attack sounds familiar. Yeah. Same thing. This Pokemon is. Ooh, wait. Is in your hand when you're setting up. You may put it as your active Pokemon. Active stage 2. What in the world? Well, damn. All right. This must be new. Search your deck for two trainer cards. Put them in your hand. This is like. I mean, this is kind of like that. I was just like playing with this guy, but that like Unfenced or something like that, where it's not that, but it's some bird where you search your deck for any two cards and you do like 40 damage, which I mean, yeah, I guess it's a little bit worse, but yeah, it's just not really a, I mean, good for trainers, but it doesn't do a lot of damage, so the exact same, like, bro, that's, bro, what the heck, they just print the exact same like art. What is that? Rotom V Star though. But any mana numbered tool cards from discard pile in your last zone. Is that the same? Yeah, but it does 40 more. Same energy cost. I guess that's just better. And I mean more health for two prizer. So that's pretty good. And then discarding number of cards from your hand, then draw that many. Oh, huh. It's pretty good. I mean, discard like four eggs, you can draw four, but you can discard any card, so it's not a terrible V Star. But yeah, that's like, I mean, definitely makes Rotom a lot better, doing 40 more damage, a lot more health. Electric, hand, possibly paralyzation. That's kind of good. A Radiant Charge It Bug. What in the world? Whenever any player touches energy from one of their hand of the Pokemon, put two damage counters on Pokemon. Because that's kind of similar to like Arc Dissolve. Except that you have to evolve this guy, but it could be on anyone, so kind of, but not really. That's any player, so I can. Okay, this isn't that good. I mean, yeah, it doesn't seem. I mean, maybe, definitely not expand, but I mean, maybe standard, because there's a lot of Vs if you want to do like spread damage and you're not playing Vs, but yeah. That's such a weird, random, like, rating to create, though, Charge It Bug. And, like, it's shiny form. I don't think the previous ratings were, like, shiny form, right? Or, oh, wait, no, they were. What the heck? I'm dumb. I just realized. Actually, all the radiants are shiny, lol. Wait, no, Heatran doesn't look shiny. I don't know. That's your aura. Zora VMAX, which isn't. Yeah, wasn't this a promo? I'm pretty sure. Or, no, the V Star was a promo. Oh, no, this is a. This was a promo as well. Jesus Christ. Okay, well, now it's in the set. I mean, it's all right. It's all right, I guess. And then, okay, so there. Okay, is this the set where they just put all the promos like into one set? What the heck is this, dude? What in the world? I don't think I ever like went over this card though. But it's one of your opponent Pokemon four times. Each time you choose Pokemon, do 60 damage to it. Okay, so you could like, yeah, you could like spread 60 damage like four times, I guess. Pinchurchin. Oh, search a deck for two basic Pokemon, put them on your bench. That's pretty good, man. There's I think there's a lot of things that do this, but isn't there like a Gossifleur? Oh, God, no, Gossifleur is three, but yeah, the Gossifleur is three basics, man. Okay, well, this is not as good. Right, psychics. Another Mew reprint. Huh. Cool art. Same exact card then. Another Lunatone reprint. Bro, just reprints upon reprints, man. Oh my god. Dusclops, no Duskull, Dust no though. Got a Lele. Same exact attack as that GX pretty much. Got a Hatterene V, a different one, right? V Max. Certain turn may move up to do damage counters from your Pokemon to your opponent's active Pokemon. Isn't that like a V star? There's something else that does something similar, I think. But not a good attack, but it doesn't seem that great. Enamorous. 140, same number of cards, not insane. More Solrocks. Not a lot of fighting Pokemon at all, what the heck. Yeah, that's not too great. I mean, 240, I mean, if you like hammered, but I don't know if that's a reprint. Like, I can't even tell at this point. What else we got? Trigalge. This is a reprint. Although with psychic though. Wasn't this like from the tag team era? Well, let me look it up. So, oh wait, no. Yeah, it was from Cosmic Eclipse. Psychic. It did 10 damage counters, but this is eight, but you have okay. Well, this is like just way worse because you have to evolve it, and then you do the extra damage. That's definitely not as good. And then another Hooper reprint. Oh my freaking! I ain't reading that, dude. Whole freaking paragraph on that card. Zacian, this is a different Zacian. 200 if they're oh that's I mean that's kind of good. 260 damage to VMAX. I guess, but I mean who the hell is gonna be playing this Zacian though, let's be honest. Over the other one. Zacian V-Star. 310, that's a lot of damage. 4 energy though. Damage that's a lot of damage though. I think that does more than what like Zacian or no, I think Zacian V Union does like 340. Yeah, it does 340. Zamazenta, so this is the same. Zamazenta, another V star. Oh my god, another freaking paragraph. Ability. All your Pokemon take 100 less damage. Okay. Okay, so I guess that's, I mean, 100 less damage, that's, I mean, that's kind of good, yeah, it's an ability, but Gudra does that pretty much with its attack, though. So, Lodirk, wait, what is this? What? Two different Rayquazas? What the heck, man? Why, though? For what reason are there two the same Rayquazas? But, bro, it's the same freaking thing, but they just flipped it pretty much, man. What is that? Why is that a thing, dude? We like there's already enough Rayquaza VMAXs, right? Man, all right. Seems and then this is like the same like this is the same print as like the original one. What the hell? Duraludon V. Another reprint. Another reprint. There's already a ton of like all of our Duraludons, man. Holy. Got Radiant Eternatus. Wow, alright. Let's Pokemon from your hand and bench. Search your deck for up to two VMAXs. Put them under bench. What the heck? Huh. That's kind of insane. Oh, your turn ends though. Okay. Your turn does end, but bro, you can just do this on like if you go first or something. I mean what VMAXs would you need like multiple of? I mean maybe like I'm not really Mew VMAX, but probably like what, like Shadow Rider VMAX? Yeah, Shadow Rider VMAX, Regi Eleki VMAX. It's 200 damage, I mean for attack, but that's actually kinda nuts. Huh. Alright. Moving on. It's not a bad tourist, honestly, but so another data reprint. EVV. Regi, yeah, I think isn't this the first? Yes, yeah, I think this is the first Regigigas V. 240 HP, wow. V-Star, if your opponent has exactly one prize card remaining, choose one of your bench Pokemon, discard it, and all attached cards. Ooh, that is very situational. Yeah, I don't know how good this is. I mean, pretty mid attack. 300 HP for a V-Star, though. What the heck? Yeah, this is kind of mid. Another Stoutland. Choose a supporter card from your opponent's discard. Oh, wait, hold on. Hold on. Hypno Mill 2.0? Wait, isn't this the same thing? Wait, this is discard. Oh, wait, no, wait. Oh, no, use it. No, use this. No, it's not, because I think this means you use the effect, not your opponent uses the effect. Yeah, never mind. God damn it, but that I mean that would have been nuts if it was just in the discard and you used it for them. That'd be actually broken because you don't even have to like use the thing that puts it back in their hand at all. Plus you wouldn't have to evolve, but yeah. The Greedent. Okay, so that's it for Pokemon. Normal Pokemon. Okay, is there gonna be a, should I even bother looking at the trainer? Is there gonna be any new trainer? Is this a new one? Seems kind of bad. I haven't really seen like all these arts. What's up with these signatures, dude? Bro, is this man's signature? What the heck? A Leon. Oh, this looks new. Sky Seal Stem. During your turn, you may use this ability. If your opponent's active Pokemon V-Star or V-Max is knocked out by damage from attack, from your basic V, take one more prize card. So what, you use this before you use the attack? That's actually kind of good, man. I mean, there's a lot of good like basic Vs that do a lot of damage. I mean, like Suicune, Blissey. A lot more. Yeah, it's pretty good. I mean, uses the V Star ability. If you don't use any other V Star abilities, it's definitely pretty good, man. One extra prize card. You don't use it once, but still. All right, so what? Like only two new trainers? I don't know if this. I mean, I guess I could check real quick. Yeah, that's down. We got some full arts. Another Lisa Sparkles. Yo, full art Roxy, please. Full art Roxy. No chance, but okay, a lot more, bro. Like a lot more. How many like full arts of like draw threes are there, man? Oh my god, that's kind of nuts. Skirt. Okay, another research. Ooh, I kind of like this one. I kind of like this art, man. Not gonna lie, but I gotta stick with my Junipers though. From Plasma Freeze, but that one's actually pretty good. And a Volo. Okay. So, huh? Yeah. I mean, I guess there's gonna be ultra rares, of course. But out of all the Pokemon, I mean, it's really not much I saw that. I mean, there's just a lot of reprints. There's not much I Only thing I took note of was that Kyogre, man. Nothing else seemed like real interesting. So it doesn't look like there's gonna be a lot of new decks I can create. You got a Pikachu. Whoa, that's a lot of Pokemon in that Pikachu card. Galarian Gallery. Oh my god. What the heck? That's a lot of stuff. More full arts. Oh my god. Okay. I mean, cool, I guess. So the other, I guess, and these are still gonna be in the reverse slot. Yeah, these are so many full arts, man. It's actually nuts how many like different arts there are for each card. You can Sword and Shield just went nuts with that, dude. Like, seriously, there's just like 10 different arts for a single card. And that was like, brotherly, that was not the case in like Sun and Moon. But yeah, let's just scroll through. Ooh, that's pretty good. Definitely use that as a mana fame. Bro, look at that Keldeo though, man. Look at that Keldeo art, bro. That's actually, bro, I'm not even being biased. That's like the sickest like trainer thing I've ever seen, dude. Oh my god. It is actually nuts. And then, I mean, this is a guy I actually used in a deck. So yeah, bro, I'm gonna be getting me about 1,000 of these cards, man. Got Electivire. Electricity, a Mew. There's already the gold one though. Oh boy, Lunatone. I freaking hate this deck on ladder. There's so many people that play it, but I see a lot of these guys. This art looks really cool as well, man. Dante, I mean, I used this in my in the Togepi, the baby Churio deck. Kobfi. Okay, this art's kind of weird. At first I didn't even like know what I was looking at, where the Pokemon was, but it's like, what in the world? Solrock. Okay, these arts are pretty sick, honestly, though. Absol, Athievo. Wow, this is it's pretty cool as well. Magnezone. Oh, that's interesting art. Latias. Ditto. What? What the heck? Okay, that's a pretty funny art. I mean, why Numel though? Why Numel? Okay, that, I mean, bro, looking at this card, like if someone was playing, like, if they opened like their first pack ever and like pulled this card, like they'd be like, oh man, like shouldn't this be like Numel? Like it's kind of weird, but I mean, it's pretty funny art, I guess. Dunsparce again, like I mean, you can barely like tell what you're like I feel like the Pokemon should be in their center of the card, like that's where I always look at. And then like, wait, there's one there, there's one there, there's one there. Like these trainer arts are really like, I mean, most of them are in the middle, but like, I mean, some of them, it's just like kind of weird, man. They're just all over the place. Miltank, Burial. This has no ability, just a regular freaking Ryolu, man. Swabba. Okay, a bunch of random, just common cards, I guess. So are these all gonna be in the reverses, man? If that's the case, then like, bro, no one's gonna be like, bro, getting all the reverses is gonna be hard. You're gonna be just pulling these guys like all the time. But all right, it's pretty cool looking though. Oh, here we go, Leafeon and Beastar. Okay. Entei V, nice. Semi-Surfy Star. What the hell is that, dude? Bunch of Pansears. Suicune V. Luminia, whoa, that one's kind of cool. The other Luminia V's pretty good as well, though. Glaceon V Star. Raikou V, dude. Damn. And this guy covered. But, like, bro, like. Bro, like I thought this was Pachirisu at first, man. That's where I'm looking, and I just look at the whole card and then get a Togemaduro or whatever over there, dude. So that was the V Max, the V Star, Mewtwo V Star. Deoxys VMAX. Wait, was that an orbital? Yeah. Hattering. It's like hard to tell what it is though. It's not even facing like this direction. The Zassian Beam. Oh, it's a psychic Zassian Beam. I mean, well, like, I thought this was a metal one at first because like the card was like all like gray and like blue. But then I like the psychic, and that's. It's just like, I don't know, man. It's just like kind of confusing, dude. It's kind of weird. Drapion Beam. Darkrai V-Star. I don't know. I don't know why this card is like colorful when it. Darkrai is kind of like, you know, the. Lead Darkness Legendary, something like that, but. Alright. Okay, how many? Wait, is there really 70? 70 character arts? What the heck? Bro, I guess this is gonna be like a huge, like, IRL collector set, but. It's just all the different art. Like, something like Shining Fates, right? All the shinies, but. I mean, the arts are, like, way better than the shinies, though. But. Dude, there's so much. It's a good art. But, like, dude, I'm looking at all these arts and, like, bro, like, I literally think Keldeo is the best art, man, out of all these. No freaking cap, dude. Zenta V. Gigas V Star. It's cool. Damn. What am I even looking at? Are these new trainers? Maybe just the fifth reprint of. I think this is the second chorus experiment. Rita, another Melanie. Wait, no, isn't this the third one? Bro, this is like the third Melanie. Like, what the heck, dude? This is getting crazy, man. It's getting ridiculous at this point. It's honestly getting ridiculous. Raihan, like, oh my god. Roxanne. Alright, here we go with the golds. Pretty critical of the golds in each set, but we got. Palkia V-Star, which there's already a Palkia V-Star gold, so that's a great start. Which I like the other art better, honestly. Like, bro, this guy looks like a horse. What the heck? If that was the origin form, I guess, yeah, because that's what it looks like. But Dialga, I don't know. I don't like these arts. They're just so small, man. They're so small. Giratina, bro, this guy looks like a tree, dude. Like, what are these like roots? Arceus V-Star. Okay, those golds suck, man. What the heck, dude? Those actually suck, dude. I'm not gonna lie. They're just so small. And then, like, there's already golds of all these guys. Is that really it? Yeah, that's really it. Associated promo cards. Yeah, so this is the trainer box. Yeah, it's just, like, the birds. Yeah, I guess that's it. I mean, pretty short video. I mean, usually my set reviews are like over an hour, but I mean, there's just not much to talk about, like new cards. Just, yeah, this is definitely a collector set. Just a lot of, I mean, it's the last like Sword Shield set, so like might as well finish. My mic just cut out, but yeah, this is a collector set, so might as well just finish it off with just like. Just reprints upon reprints, I guess. It's gonna be fun to open up the packs in game, but I mean, actually, the sets are out, so let me look at what's most expensive about the set real quick. Let me see. So, 60 packs for Giratina V Star. Why do people want a Giratina? Yeah, people are buying Arceus for 50, Palkia V-Star for 40, Radiant Eternus is 25 packs though. This guy's 25 packs. I mean, yeah, this guy did look pretty nuts. I mean, like, if you go first, like, that's kind of insane. I wonder what decks people are using that onto, but let's see what else. Lisa Sparkles, a high up there, Arita. Oh, Sky Sealstone is like 15 packs at least right now. Wow. So people definitely want, and it's just like a, or no, it's not a regular train. It's a rare slot, but Yeah, this is pretty expensive. Yeah, I mean, like, just all like the already good reprints. Hatterene VMAX is 10 packs, though. Really, Hatterene is 10 packs. I didn't think this was that great, but interesting. I wonder how much Keldeo is. Probably not much, because it's still not that playable. Yeah, we weren't buying for too much, but yeah, overall, yeah, I mean, cool set. Light reprints, all that. But yeah, definitely, I mean, yeah, definitely gonna play that Kyogre deck, and then maybe, I mean, I did, this one looked, I mean, alright, but yeah, probably not. You never know. Maybe, but yeah, you never know. But yeah, I'm gonna wrap up the video here. So if you guys did enjoy watching, make sure you leave a like, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and yeah, see you guys later. Peace out.